This project started in a little bit different way than my projects normally do. So, I was just sitting there, working in my shop, one afternoon.
Kylo Ren, what are you doing here?
Are you the industrial maker? I need you to make me a lightsaber.
Oh, you just want a lightsaber, Kylo? Come on, man.
You will make me a lightsaber.
Can't you see I'm in the middle of building this LED matrix? I can't make you a light.
Make it for me. Now.
I'll make you a lightsaber.
After that, I didn't want to let Kylo down. So I made him a crossguard saber, and I made him raise saber, which we know he wants. And I had to give it that industrial maker something special, so these sabers both have a party mode. So let's get into a summary of everything we use for the build.
And I wanted to do this in a way that looks nice. It's got some metal hilts, but isn't going to break the bank. But what I'm going to do is use some neopixels and some plumbing parts to make one for about $80. The parts are going to be what you can find almost entirely at any Home Depot plumbing aisle, except for a 1-inch polycarbonate tube that you're going to want to buy from Amazon. To make the hilt, we're going to use a 1¼-inch drain and a 1½-inch drain extension tube. We're going to put them together with O-rings. Then to make the blade, we're going to use a 1¼-inch PVC pipe, which we're going to paint black. We're going to put that into a 1-inch polycarbonate tube, which we can then put into the end of the pop-up drain.
So now that you've got that overview, let's get into the details of making the hilt.
First thing we're going to do is we're going to remove the drain plug from the pop-up drain. We're going to want to cut off most of the drain pipe so that we have as much room as possible inside of the extension tube for the battery holder.
So we unscrewed it and took the pipe to the miter saw to cut.
You can pretty much hold the drain and the extension tube together by putting O-rings around the drain pipe so that it will then fit inside and snugly with the extension. But since this is a lightsaber and you're probably going to want to be dueling with it, we're going to actually use a 1/4 20-inch threading drill bit in order to drill some holes in the extension tube that go through and match mating holes in the pipe so we can use screws to hold these together.
To really make this look like a high-end saber, we're going to use an LED push button to turn the saber on and switch modes. The LED button is threaded and has a nut, so we'll just need to drill a 5/8-inch hole in the hilt to make room for it.
To make the bottom cap for the lightsaber, we're going to use the slip ring that actually came with the extension tube and screws onto it. The slip ring is hollow and doesn't form a cap. So what I've done is take a piece of acrylic that I had lying around, and you can use some scrap wood or acrylic or a piece of metal, whatever you can cut with a jigsaw, to cut a circle to match and fit inside of the slip ring.
Now we've got a screw-on cap for the bottom of the hilt that allows us to access and change the batteries. Moving on, we'll do the wiring for the Arduino and the LEDs. Now I used WS2813 individually addressable LED strips, which have a redundant data wire, so there's four wires. And you might also use strips that are WS2812s, which only have three wires or one control line. Either will work. We're going to send one control signal to both LED strips. So what you see me doing here is wiring the power and ground together for both LED strips, and then wiring the other end of the power and ground wires to a battery holder for four AA batteries. One thing to note is that you want to use 1.2 volt rechargeable batteries, not regular 1.5 volt batteries, because four of those would be too much for the 5 volt LEDs. Note, I'm also using a JST on the battery holder so that it can be connected and disconnected easily. Then I connected the second power and ground lines on the LED strips and the control lines, all four of them in this case, to another JST so it could be easily connected and disconnected from a mating JST on the Arduino. Using these JST quick connect adapters does add complexity to the wiring, but it's going to make our life a lot easier when we're trying to get all the electronics inside the hilt of the lightsaber. So what you see me doing here is wiring 3-pin JST quick connectors to the Arduino Nano for both the LED button and the LED strips. So for those of you who might not have worked with electronics much before, a JST quick connector is just a simple connection that allows you to connect and disconnect power, ground, and a control signal quickly between two components, for example, between the Arduino Nano and the LEDs. And I've got links in the video description for this and all the other parts that you need to make this saber. The last part we need to wire is a JST going to the LED push button. This is a momentary push button, which means that it stays in one state all the time except for when it's pressed. We're going to follow the wiring diagram that came with it to wire it in a normally closed position so that it is always closed and the LED light is always on except for when it's pressed. When you press it, the light turns off and it goes to a zero or is open. And this is the signal that our code will use to switch between different modes. And once all this is wired, we're going to plug the Arduino into our computer so that we can upload the code. Now, before you upload, you're going to want to download the Arduino file that I linked to in the video description for the Saber. You're going to open that in the Arduino application. Then you're going to make sure that you have set your controller to an Arduino Nano and selected the output port for your Arduino Nano. One other thing to note is that you're going to need to have downloaded the FastLED library to make this work. You're also going to set the LED pin variable to whatever pin you connected your LEDs to on your Arduino and set the switch pin variable to whatever pin you connected your LED button to on your Arduino. Then you can upload it to your Arduino Nano and it's ready to go.
So I don't actually have footage of me making the blade itself, but it's very simple. It's just gonna be your 1-inch polycarbonate tube, which you're gonna cut with a miter saw to be whatever length you want, plus an inch or so, because remember, it's gonna actually extend into the hilt somewhat. Then we're gonna take a 1¼-inch PVC pipe, which we're gonna spray paint black, and happens to fit pretty much perfectly around that. And once you use some super glue to put that together, you'll have a really nice blade. I've got the blade here with the LEDs already put inside of it. We're going to go now and show you how I got the LEDs with the packing tape diffuser inside of the blade.
To make the blade, I used super glue to attach the two LED strips back to back. Then I wrapped those strips in packing foam and inserted the packing foam wrapped strips into the polycarbonate tube. Bob over on I Like to Make Stuff used a really similar technique to make the blade for his lightsaber, so I'll leave a link to that video in the description if you want to see more details on the blade. And I have to apologize because I somehow didn't get footage of myself actually putting the diffuser in the blade.
So now we've got all the electronics assembled and we're ready to put everything together. Before we put the blade and the drain pipe together, we're going to put the button into the 5/8-inch hole that we drilled in our drain pipe, and then use the nut that came with it to secure it to the drain pipe. So now we're going to take the JST connector to the LEDs and the power connector, and we're going to thread that through the drain pipe. Now we're going to connect the LED button and the LED strips to the Arduino with the JST connectors. We've got all of the electronics inside of the drain pipe, which is the top part of our hilt. And all we've got to do is connect our extension tube to the drain pipe, thread the power through, and connect it to the battery holder. We'll be right back. before we put the battery holder into the hilt and permanently connect everything, we're gonna do a quick test run. Just plug the battery holder into the power jack, make sure everything works. The LED should light up, and if you did the code right, your LED strip should also light up. All that's left to do is put on the bottom cap that we made and attach it to the slip joint. And then our lightsaber is ready for its first duel with the First Order.
Most of the footage in this video is of me building the Rey / Anakin Skywalker saber because I built it second and had to iron the kinks out for the process. However, I obviously built a Kylo Ren saber too and want to show you some of the differences with that.
It's basically going to be the same, except that you're going to want to add the crossguard. To add the crossguard, I discovered that if you have a 3/4 inch PVC T connector, it actually is going to be a 1 inch inside diameter and will accept the 1 inch polycarbonate too. I then took pieces of 1 1/4 inch pipe here, which you can see are basically the same size as the T, and I just super glued those onto the T so that I could put small pieces of 1 inch polycarbonate tube on either side, and you get the cross guard effect that was similar to what we saw Kylo Ren's in the movies. So there's two sets of code for the Kylo Ren saber and the regular lightsaber. They're both going to power on the same way, but once they power on, they behave differently. So the regular lightsaber is going to power on and then just have like a slight pulsing of saturation and hue to give it a sort of glowing pulsing effect. Kylo Ren saber, because it's unstable, is going to have a flaming and sparking effect that is much more noticeable.
Kylo, you're back. I didn't expect you so soon. I think it's ready. Let's give it a try. Let me know what you think.
You have restored my faith in you. I believe everyone should subscribe to the Industrial Maker channel and click the thumbs up button below. Wait, did you say that this saber has a party mode?
Power of the Dark Side. Ha, 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 ha.